Hello everyone, this is Subrim, a legal intern at Lexis & Company and currently pursuing BLLB honors from Central University of South Bihar. As you have seen in the previous session that we had dealt with the writ of quo warranto, and in this video I will be describing the conditions for the issue the writ of quo warranto. So in this video, in the previous video, I has told the four conditions for issue of writ of quo warranto. That is, the office must be public in nature, it must be created by a statute or by the constitution itself, and that the office must be a substantive one and not merely the function or employment of a servant at the will and during pleasure of another. And the last one was, the holder must be in actual occupation of the office. So let us see the first part, that is public office, that related to public office. So by saying the word public office, we mean that those offices in which public has an interest. Before issuing the writ of quo warranto, the court must satisfy that the office in question is public in nature. In the case of G.D. Karwakke versus T.L. Sedway, G.D. Karwakke is the petitioner applied to the High Court for the writ of quo warranto against the Advocate General of the state on the allegation that he was guilty of intrusion into the office of the Advocate General for at the date of appointment. He did not possess the necessary qualifications prescribed by the Constitution for that office. It was held that a writ of quo warranto could be issued as the office of the Advocate General was a part of public nature. So the writ of quo warranto will not lie in respect of an office of a private nature. It was said in the case of R versus Mosley. In the case of Jamalpur Arya Samaj versus D. Ram, the petitioner moved to High Court for issue of writ in the nature of quo warranto against the members of the working committee of the Bihar Raj Arya Pratinidhi Sabha, a private religious association. The court refused the writ on the ground that a writ of quo warranto does not lie against an office of a private nature. So now let us see the second condition, that is a statutory nature. The office must be statutory or constitutional in nature. Thus, a writ of quo warranto may be issued in respect of offices of the Prime Minister, Advocate General, High Court Judge, Public Prosecutor, Speaker of the House of the State Legislature, Member of Municipal Body and others. Now the third condition is substantive character. The office must be of substantive character. By saying the word substantive character, we mean that the office must be an independent official and not merely one discharging the function of a deputy or servant upon the will and pleasure of others. The fourth condition was the actual occupation. The holder must be in an actual occupation of the office and he must have asserted the right to claim it. Mere claim to an office is not enough to justify issuance of quo warranto. Such claims must be coupled with occupation and aspiration. The writ of quo warranto is discretionary in nature and the petitioner is not necessarily entitled to issue a writ. By saying it's upon the discretion of the court, we mean that they may either grant or refuse the issue writ, taking into account the facts and the circumstances of the case. So, the writ of quo warranto has a very specific target, but its rules of locus standi are considerably relaxed compared to other writs. As we have discussed above, the writ of quo warranto can only be issued against the against an office that is independent, public, and substantive. However, anyone can pray for that writ. The writ of quo warranto, moreover, gives the judiciary a weapon to control the executive from making appointments to public office against law, and protects a citizen from being deprived of public office to which he has a right. That's all for now. Let's meet you in the next session. So please do like and subscribe the channel for further updates. Thank you.